we click on the Patch by Name button to activate this powerful tool. The search engine works on both user and system labels within a device. That means we are not forced to name channels to use this function, and we can easily work with mixed names, speeding up the whole process and granting maximum flexibility. For both inputs and outputs, the more we type, the more the channel range is narrowed. We have to select just one input, while we can select multiple outputs. Let's have a look at a few examples working on different devices. On a fresh Xbox MD, meaning with no user labels but just system ones, we can type S on the input search field. Immediately, the input list is showing us all the channels' names starting with an S. So we have 64 SFP and 64 SC channels. If we then type an F, the list is much shorter, showing just the 64 SFP channels. We can probably decide now to scroll the list and click on the desired input channel. Let's say we want to patch the selected input to just one output, for example, Dante out 34. The search engine is not case sensitive, so we can quickly type Dante out 34, select the only output found in the list and confirm the patch with return, or with a click on the button name Patch Selected. Once patched, the color of the output name becomes blue, meaning that now it has as source the channel selected on the input search field. Underneath the Patch by Name panel, the grid has been graphically refreshed, showing the last crosspoint set. This is very useful when the crosspoint is just a starting point for further related patching. We can disable the Patch by Name with a click on the relevant button and complete the patch with further channels using other tools, adding, for example, another 7 subsequent channels after the starting point previously and quickly set by name. In case we want to patch one input to more than one output, we can proceed in different ways. We can type some letters on the output search field and, once happy about the content of the list, we can select a range of output using Shift and Click and/or adding individual channels using Command plus Click on Mac or Control plus Click on PC. The selected outputs are highlighted in the list. The number of currently selected output is shown into the Patch and Unpatch selected buttons. We can now proceed by pressing Return or with a click on the Patch Selected button. A different way to quickly patch or unpatch channels is scrolling the output list and pressing Return. We can unpatch the selected output channels with a click on the relevant button, or we can unpatch the entire current output list with a click on the Unpatch All button. In this case, a confirmation is required to proceed. Let's now make an example with user labels. For example, on a M1K2 MADI router. We know we have an input channel named Test Tone. Maybe we don't even remember now from which MADI input port is coming from. No worries. We also know we have a bunch of output channels named IFB followed by a number on different MADI outputs. Let's say we want to make a quick test of all the IFB outputs using that test tone. Few keystrokes and a click on Patch All and we are ready to go. Once finished the test, we can quickly clear those patches with a click on the Unpatch All button. Powerful, easy, globcon.